When you know about what are vectors and what are scalars, let's move into the representation of vectors subtopic. Now, as you see, it says representation of vectors means how do you show or depict or represent your vectors. So, vectors, as you know, should have both direction as well as magnitude. So, when you have to represent, you have to definitely represent both the two things. That means direction also and magnitude also. So, if I have an unlimited length means like this, if I have unlimited length sort of thing, which should be definitely a straight line, since I am drawing without a ruler or a scale, it is coming out to be a bit twisted. So, I have PQ. Now, PQ is what? If I say PQ is a vector, I will show it like this with a directed line segment having an arrow to, means a ray. Now, this PQ can also be named as, say, a vector which is only small p. So, if you want to name a vector using small alphabet, only one alphabet is sufficient. Arrow should be made. But if you want to show it using two alphabets, then you have to use capital letters and those two should be there. The other thing, PQ is equal to P vector. Now, PQ means the initial point as well as the final point, which is known as the terminal point, is very much important to know. The initial point is P and the terminal point is Q, means the vector direction or sense is from P to Q. See, three important terms that I will talk about. One is your magnitude of the vector. Magnitude of the vector is also called as the length of the vector, and that is nothing but the distance from P to Q or between P and Q. So, if this is an unlimited line and I say this is your point P and I say this is your point Q, then what is the length? Whatever is the distance from P to Q. So, that is the talking about magnitude or length. Now, the magnitude or length is mentioned as, if it is small p, so I will just say that magnitude is the modulus of p, that means it is never negative, or simply I can write it is small p. Now, next is about magnitude and length. If I have done, I will talk about the sense. The sense is also called as the direction. Now, what is the direction? When I go from p to q, I say the direction is from p to q. If it is the other way around, if you have a diagram like this, this is Q, this is P, and I'm going from Q to P, I will write Q first, then P. So, the first thing that you write is called as the initial, and the next one is known as the terminal. Last but not the least, but not very important also, that is why I left it, is your support. Now, what is support? It is nothing but based on the unlimited line on which this given vector or the directed line segment is a part of. So, this unlimited line is basically the part from where I have taken a vector, so that is known as a support. So, now you have many things into your mind that for representation of vectors we always use a arrow, that is a ray, and that ray will go from the terminal towards the terminal from the initial point. And I also know what are the three important terminologies. The first being the magnitude of a vector, shown by simply modulus because it is non-negative. The second being the direction. Direction I can write from P to Q or from Q to P and so on. The third, last but not the least, being your support. Now, what is your support? Your support is basically the unlimited line out of which the line segment that you are taking into picture is a part of.